Hello everyone, this is Mayo doing a playthrough on Nakoosa Sands GC Major by Mr. Jeremy Mayo, Mayday 91283. This is his entry in the Major Design course. Be playing this, what I call is kind of true sim. Pretty much everything turned off except for the green grid. I left that on because I cannot read greens for beans. So yeah, here we go. Let's try this course out. So basically I'll be just relying on the top view. So what do we have here? We have a hole number 1, 491 yards, par 4, stroke index of 7. We got wind in the face. What's that, 318 to the middle of the fairway, should be around there. We go. All right, puts us in the middle of the fairway. All right, so what we got left? We got between 180 to 100 yards to the pin. Very little elevation. With wind in the face, so the fairway looks slopes left to right. But that wind should compensate for it. Okay, I'm gonna stick with a 4-iron. Come on, get up there. It's gonna roll right off. All right, so we got 16 to 18 yards to the pin, and it is 3 feet up. I'm just gonna drop down a club, loft it up a bit. Whoa. Put it as a chip here. Alright, let's see now. Pitching wedge, go down to the sand wedge. Oh, get up. Should have stuck with the pitching wedge. Alright, so the greens are at 181. 16, what, 17 feet? Yeah, let's do it. So I'll put it at 19. And we just miss it. So I guess we're starting off with a bogey. Number 2, short par 4, 410 yards, stroke index of 5. Seems like the course is in the boreal theme. Alright, so what do we got? It's 23 feet downhill. We should be able to make it to the end of the fairway there. Should be fine with the driver. Yeah, perfect. All right, so 120 to 130. It's definitely gonna go left to right. All it down. Alright, should be able to pick up a bar. Hole 3, it's a long par 5 at 617 yards, playing one of the easiest holes though. Of course reminds me of Nakoosa Pines, another one of Mayo's work, beautiful course. And we got a left to right wind, let's see here, this uphill. That's the only problem with true sim. Sometimes you need something to gauge where you're aiming. I'm assuming it's going to be around there. Let's hope. Alright, that'll work. So there's no way we're getting there in two. All right, so we got, say about 340. Wanna go to 40. Up to the 1 iron. That fast. Whoa, okay, that was a big miscalculation on my end here. Alright, let's try to scramble out of here. Okay, so we're in a heavy rough, 80 to 85 yards. Stick with the sand wedge and loft it up a bit. I'll take that. Get in. Okay. The number 4 is 495 yard par 4, stroke index of 11. So what do we have to that bunker? Ooh, 321. So I'm trying to keep it left of that bunker. Okay, I can see it from here. So if we aim, it should be around there. Well, it played perfectly. Alright, so between 160 to 180 to the pin, we do have the wind at our backs, 15 feet up. gonna go midway, so 170, so it'll be like 175. I'm gonna stick with the 8-iron. And just give it a couple notches up. Loft it up a bit. And hopefully I made the right decision. Oh, get up. Alright, sit now. Sit. Ah. We're on the green. Left it short. All right. Number 5 is a short par 4, 362 yards, stroke index of 13. In fairway bunkers to mess you up, and it is uphill. Okay, so we got 236 for the first bunker, 345. It's 100 yards from there to the green. What is 253? I'll stick with the 2-wood. Okay, so 85 to 90 yards. I'm just gonna go lob wedge full. And aim right of the flag. Whoa, what did I just do? Ah, chip. Ah, come on. I hit that fast. Oof. Not the easiest of chips here. I'll take that. Well, not bad so far. Plus 1 to the first par 3, so 220 yards. This looks like it's downhill. The stroke index of 3. Just gotta look at this green. So it slopes left to right. Okay. Oh, bite. All right, so we got 16 to 18 yards. Stick with the gap wedge. I shouldn't have lofted that with gap wedge. I thought I'd get more roll. All right, so. 11, 12, 15. Get in the hole. Aww. That's gonna be another bogey. Alright, the hole 7, it's 487 yard par 4, stroke index of 9. Let's see, how's this green? Alright, not an easy pin. That'll play. Alright, so we got left 110 to 120. Gonna be enough. Get up. Come on. Short. All right, hole number 8. It's a long par 4, 510 yards, stroke index of 15. So yeah, so I started playing this kind of true sim. But I left the green grid on because seriously, I'm a really hard time reading the greens in the game with no grid. But I want to make it a bit more challenging, so I took the precise distance off and just the range right now. With a very tiny green. I'm just double checking the brakes. Okay. It is downhill. If I aim, oh, it's not going to be an easy tee shot here. See the bunker there. I'm going to try to turn it. Let's see if this should be good like this. Get over. Tried to do too much there. Alright, so what do we got? Between 180 and 200 to the pin. It's 14 feet down. We're gonna go with 180. It's 183. 6 iron. Ooh, I don't have any hot club for this. Alright, so. Okay, I'm just gonna try to aim towards the green here. You know what? I'm gonna go with the 4. And just loft it up. Ooh. That might just work. Well, that worked. Yeah, so this is how I've been doing my casual rounds. I created another account on my PS4. So I have one golfer just for the tournaments, for the TGC tours and my societies, and this one I just play my casual rounds. 6, 8, what, 9. Right there. Get in. Oh, come on. Alright. The final hole on the front nine seems to be the hardest hole. 226 yard par 3. We got that pin sitting on a shelf. Alright, so it's playing about 230. We got that wind. I'm gonna stick with the 1 iron. It's turning left. Way left. And that was way too much club. Oh, it's true, I can't read. Meh. Alright, so it's definitely gonna be left to right. Okay, so 60 to 70 feet. Let's say 65, and it's 2 feet up. So about 84. Much. It's around there. Oh yeah, I don't think I hit it enough. Nope, definitely not. All right, so. Alright, seems we're gonna finish with another bogey. Alright, so plus 3 on the front 9 on Nakoosa Sands GC by Mayo. And we're off to start the back 9. Hole number 10 is 455 yard par 4, stroke index of 6. Just try to go over those bunkers. Is that enough? Yep. Alright, so this is definitely... Alright, so let's see, 170. 50 feet up. 180. Bite. 16 to 18 feet. 1 foot up. Number 11. Short par 3 is 166, playing as the easiest hole so far. A sharp. That green breaks very sharp down. This is definitely not going to be easy. So it's definitely 177. 72. All right. Is that turning too much? All right, sit, sit, sit. Ah. I don't see how this could be playing the, as the easiest hole. Somebody must have aced this thing. Boy. Alright, so we got 41 feet. That's 18, so what, 60. Get in. Oh. All right, I'll take a par. Alright, number 12 is a 617 yard par 5. That's the second par 5 that's over 600 yards. Stroke index of 8. To that point, 54. I can't see the bunkers. Ah, I'm gonna assume. All right, I'm just gonna play it over here. All right, right in the bunkers. All right, it's a par 5. Okay, what do we got? We got 260 to the pin. Try to hit that little patch of fairway. It's gonna definitely shoot right with that wind. All right, let's go for it. Didn't get there. All right, so at 90-95. Let's stick with that sandwich. Get up. Didn't hit it enough. Not one birdie yet. All right, number 13, 497 yard par 4, stroke index of 2. Let's check out that green. Again, hard to see the fairway, so it's hard to aim. Come on, hold. There you go. All right. Come on. Okay, 160, 180. I'm gonna stick with the 8 iron. Come on, turn. Turn. There you go. Alright, pick up a birdie. Alright, number 14 is a 485 yard par 4, stroke index of 10. I just realized there's no water. Unless I missed it, but not that you need it. Alright. Well, we got the wind in the back. Okay, so 313 to the end there, but we're going to run out of fairway, so... I think should be around there. Should be able to drive it over those fairways. Actually, here, I'm gonna go more this way. There we go. Alright, stop ball. Nice. Okay. That was a lucky bounce. Down. Come on. Ooh. Just died. That's a wicked pin. Oof. Did not want to miss that one. Alright, 15. 159 yard par 3. This is 12 feet down, so 144, 148, I think the, just a full 9 iron here. I do have a backstop, so even if a bit long, it should, the ball should come back, hopefully. Looking good. Wow, that completely died. Probably didn't hit it 100%. Let's chip this. 12 to 14 feet. Oof. 16, so 426 yard par 4, stroke index of 16. I think when I have. Alright, so. What, 280 to those bunkers? We're gonna bust the wind. One iron. Should be good with the one iron. It's a short bar four, anyways. Okay, so 130 is elevated. I should bring it back a bit. I'll take that. Turn. Hit that too hard. Took all the brake out. All right, 17, 620 arc par 5. Gonna let it go through so I can see how the green is set up. Ooh, pins all the way in the back. It's gonna be one long hole. Alright, here we go. So I'm aimed directly at the flag. 300, 350 yards, let's say 340. I want to go 240. Stick with the. Get in the bunker. Okay, so 80-85 yards, 8 feet up. Sit. Nice. Get away with a birdie here. Come on, turn. Alright, to the final hole on Nakoosa Sands. We'll end with a par 3. And the leaderboard? Okay, so it's 183, 25 feet up. Only 188. Come back. Oh, so it's breaking at the left of it's right around there. Get in. All right. Plus two. I'll take that. I thought it was going to play a lot harder than that. Maybe I just got lucky. And maybe I'll try it on harder settings. Definitely gonna come back and play pin 2 with the settings that Jeremy suggested. Beautiful course. Reminds me a lot of Nisida Pines with the bunkering. And yeah, and good luck in the contest. What? Definitely one of the top ones.